anything for him to love you, he just does.
Yeah.
I want to read you this quote by Ian Morgan. It says, God is love. He didn't need us, but he wanted us. And that is the most amazing thing.
Amen.
I know many of us have been in relationships where we're married or we were single at one point or another, but we've been in relationships where the person says they love us and doesn't feel like it. How many of us have been guilty of basing our love that God has for us depending on what he does for us or doesn't do? As we have learned in our walk with him, this is not how a relationship works. But why do we do this? Mostly because this is how we treat everyday relationships. We learn from our parents, or we think that's what love should be, and it's not. One of the very first things we have to know and understand is that God is love. The very thing we are seeking from others and trying to understand, he is. Yes, we can look at the definition, as I mentioned, and see that it tells us that it's an intense feeling of deep affection. But what you need to understand is that God is love. He is the true definition. So I'm going to give you some points today of how you can know that he is love and that he loves you. And the first one that I'm going to give you is that God is love. And the scripture that I'm going to come from is 1 John 4, 7, and 8. It says, beloved, let us love one another, for love is of God. And everyone that loveth is born of God and knoweth God. Verse 8 says that he that loveth not knoweth not God, for God is love. This scripture is important because he calls us beloved. I have an aunt. Her name is Aunt Joyce. She lives in Seattle. And anytime you call her, as soon as she answers the phone and she knows who she's speaking to, she says, hello. It's so sweet. It really is. And if you knew who she was, you know exactly that that's where her heart and that's where she comes from. Yes, we get love from our parents, our significant others, but based on the scripture, it says that whoever loves has been born of God and knows him or knows God. So if you're loving on someone and you don't know God, it's not the right time. Because in order to give love, you have to get it from him first. Amen? Because basically what's happening is you are technically giving them a counterfeit.
That's good.
Not only are you giving it, you might also be receiving counterfeit if that person doesn't know God.
Right.
You are loving based on what you think you know love to be, and you can't love correctly until you love God and know God first. You can't love God correctly until you know him. You can't love your wife until you know him. You can't love your husband until you know him.
Yes.
You can't love your children until you know him. You must know him to understand the true essence of what love is. Without him, you don't know. You just don't know. It also says that anyone who does not love God. That's strong right there. So you go around saying, I love you, girl. No, you don't. I love you, boy. Why are you saying you love him? Did you say it first? Okay, boy. It brings me to the time when me and Rob were dating. Ooh, you didn't know I was going to share this. Okay, great. We were at his mom's church, and you know, this wonderful turquoise sweater that I love so much. And we were like at a play or something. This was like in the beginning of our relationship. And he reaches his hand around me and he says in my ear, I love you. And I said, I know. And then, no, he said it again because my husband, anybody will mind it. He's very persistent. And He said that again. He's like, I love you. I know, I really love you. And I was like, I know. Thank you. Thank you very much. But it's weird because, you know, dating and stuff, you say, I love you. You don't love that person. You just love them because they took you out to dinner. Or you love them because they bought you a new outfit. But that's not love. You know what I'm saying? And that might sound like a funny story, but when I met Jerron again, because anybody knows our story, it's like we went to elementary school together, and then we met up again some other time. And saw my mom at the BP station, and then I saw him somewhere else. And then it's like we cannot not see each other ever in life. So it's just that at that point in time, because I had dealt with some knuckleheads before him, I was like, look, I'm not saying I love this person unless I really mean it. So that's kind of the commitment I made to myself. And it probably took me a whole year, which is probably sad.
No, it didn't.
Oh, please. But it took a while. It was more than a week, at least. My point is that you can't love properly without knowing how. And the only true love that you can be experienced is from him. Once you experience this kind of love, you can love properly your neighbor, your family, your community, your church, your spouse, and why? Because you know what love is, because it came from God, and you've experienced it, and you truly understand it. Amen?
Amen.
Number two.